Nah.
SF would be alright. Versus Death Prophet, versus Bloodseeker.
It's getting rough.
Yeah. Meanwhile, in the bottom lane, Raven jumping forwards. Bok, maybe in a bit of trouble here as Zephyr's on top of him. He has got Fairy Fire, but can't get it off. He's got to get dropped, and that's going to be a first blood for Raven. Exactly what GeekFam want down in this bottom lane. Get off that blood, right? A little bit of extra slow there. Meanwhile, they certainly are. Raven trying to run down the Necrophos. Fairy Fire comes out. Boomy realizing he has to come with the blocks here, but in comes Zephyr from behind. They get themselves one. They're going on to Boomy as well. It's going to be two down in the bottom lane for GeekFam. They take down both Bok and Boomy. He's kind of wondering what to do with himself. I don't know, maybe setting up something later on. Maybe they can rotate in more heroes from GeekFam, but their bottom lane is being pushed in, so kind of seems difficult. Now his ping is coming out. Meanwhile, down to the bottom lane, they're going on to Natsumi. This Bloodseeker, he throws down the Rupture, but he's getting run down here. The Pounce is going to connect. Right click's coming through, even the ultimate thrown in from Raven just to secure this kill. Meanwhile, up at top, Cuckoo jumps in, but the Reaper Sight is going to come down. The first kill on the board from Adroit, and it will be Lead Commander in the bin for 40 seconds.
And to answer your question, that mid tower is more important because you want to control Rosh and you want to not leave a gap in your defenses like this.
Yep, that leads into the easy pickup in box. So yeah, definitely agreeing with you on that one. And proving your point beautifully, eloquently, some might say, is Mac trying to play around here. Raven, he's just charging at him right now. They know there's no exits up. Mac, what is the actual plan here? Zephyr comes in, throwing down the slab, and the Great Grim coming down as well. Gives them the damage they need to finish off that Death Prophet. And CML is kind of in the wrong neighborhood right now. And this is going to be a nice, tasty little duel for Cuckoo. A little side salad to their main course of Death Prophet. And of course, that starter, the Necrophos, kicking it all off. Yeah, they might be looking for something here. Cuckoo, he's invis'd up. And here we go. What a GeekFam turning in. The X-Staff's gonna go down immediately to open up his kill. And Matt getting dueled up, brought down super fast here. Bok, he's in the trees. He's actually blocked in by this fish. Akal's gonna get right on top of him, throwing some raises. He's pretty tanky on this Necrophos, but at the same time, where do you run? Rook's being thrown in the backlands here, but Bok, he's just kind of being played with right now. The Yule's gonna make him waste most of this ghost form. And now the damage come through, and Bok is most certainly gonna get a soup stirred down here.
Yeah, sadly, so no way to use that exorcism for two targets at once. And GeekFam is just moving forward immediately. They're like, hey, exorcism is down. It's go time.
Yeah, they realize that this is the timing for them as they jump in. Raven gonna immediately jump onto the Chen, trying to control him out, trying to force out the hand of God early as well, but they're being blocked up pretty badly, yeah. So not the smoothest of initiations from GeekFam here. We'll see what Adroit can do about this. I mean, it's Bloodseeker versus Slark right now, so they try to jump on each other. Meanwhile, Cuckoo, he's gonna get torn off in the backline here. We're gonna buy back and try coming onto the shrine. Meanwhile, Natsumi, he's getting run down, and Raven, he's not able to finish the job though. Natsumi makes himself away. Meanwhile, Boomy running away. Raven just going on a rampage right now, finding whoever he wants, and will be able to get the first kill for himself. Meanwhile, CML gets dropped by the Chatterfiend in the backline. Meanwhile, they're gonna jump onto the Bloodseeker. Can they find him? Yes, they can. Jump forward from Zephyr. Meanwhile, Matt realizing he needs to get himself out. BKB, TP himself home. Three heroes there on the side of Adroit though. A buyback from the Legion Commander, but totally worth it, as now GeekFam immediately running up on this high ground. Adroit, what do you do, guys? And immediately jump forward to the fucking big cord out. The fish catches him, and look at that, they just tear him in two. A buyback forced out from two of these heroes, as both the Bloodseeker and the Necrophos coming back into this one. GeekFam, they're not leaving for now, though. They're going to take the tower, take a couple of creeps, and now they're going to try and make a leisurely escape. Or will they, as the Blink does dodge out the pounce, but now they just find Bok. And Bok, is he able to do anything about this? He might just get off the ghost trap. In comes the Yule. K's on top of him. Razors come through, and the Necrophos is out for the count. Mac just sitting here wondering what to do with Mike. GeekFam are diving. And they are diving hard as they find the Death Prophet. They get the dive back on her. A duel CML killed off as well. They're in the fountain now. Raven chopping them apart. But there's your GGs coming out for GeekFam as they take game number one. Wow, that went from 0 to 100 real damn fast.
This game, if they continuously make those misplays again, AM is going to take over the game.
And right now, they're laying into Boomy, which is a little bit too far.
Yeah, this is looking like a first blood here for GeekFam. So, you know, good start to the game for them. Getting kill onto the Shaker always feels pretty good. Adroit, they are feeling a bit threatened here because there's a couple of heroes missing on the map, but the PL, he's got his spider senses, or cat senses, I guess, tingling, and gets himself back to the other side of the map. But they're not done. Uh-oh, this could be a dangerous camp to farm right now. He's already used the Doppelganger as well. Now they're going to get on top of him, but the Puck is here, trying to control them up. Slan's going to come out as well as Natsumi. He gets, like, he's going to kick off by the Chain Frost. Oh dear, CML, get away. Puck going to go down as well as GeekFam find a hugely profitable engagement up in the top side of the Rhodium map. Goodness me, that was Cuckoo. Hello, sir. He's feeling himself right now, and for good reason. Carl's here to back him up. They're going to try and get done onto Boomy here, but he's dropping low on the Void Spirit. Can they finish the job? Yes, they can. A little bit overambitious there from Cuckoo. GeekFam, they have two heroes smoked here. I imagine they're going for some vision. Yeah, they are. And Natsumi's like, wait a minute, what's going on here? I just see a hero looking forward onto this one as, they're getting wrapped around upon, but they get the PL.
Oh.
Carl, you're able to get the pick off here. I think Adroit were a little bit slow to react to that one. Two folks on getting the kills in the backland and not keeping their PL safe. The White Mon diving around the trees here is going to get killed off. Meanwhile, Merc looking for something here. He's looking for Zephyr. Is he going to find him though, Zephyr? He's in a bit of a naughty position. He uses the Waning Rift again and gets himself to safety.
Yeah, hide those last hits.
And this is where you really want to have... Cuckoo jumping in for his core.
Yeah, he's trying to save Raven, trying to just provide the big distraction here, and it's actually giving them a bit of a razzle-dazzle here, but unfortunately, he will not be able to get out. Although I say that, Geekhammer coming in, oh my goodness! The scream comes through, a Druid get cut in two, my word! They are gone! Maybe a different hero that could push without it, then sure, I mean, the game would feel better, but I don't know, it's a hard one to look at like that, as Mackie's getting in trouble in the middle lane here. They're trying to get him away here. Science comes out from Bok. Mack, though, he needs to run. He's going to throw down the coil and get himself... Oh, nice scream coming out from Carl there. Sonic Wave, and he's got no choice but to come back into existence right in the middle of that big old scream, and Raven, he is by no means done with this. Clumsy net. Oh, well, it's going to buy space for the Antimage to get in as PL's illusions come over, but the real boy is not coming up to this one. No chance. And Boomy might have just thrown his lot into the run box in this occasion here, as he's now stuck in the trees, surrounded and getting brought down. He is drowned up in the top lane.
Just because otherwise he wouldn't escape with his life.
Roshan is happening right now. The science is going to come out. They're going to try and delay this one. I feel like they have to. Phantom Lancer taken to the front lines with the illusions here, trying to voice them out. And they've actually been able to do so. Exism has been popped for this one. And it feels like Geekfam
are
willing to let it fall. Really? Cuckoo being controlled, but they get Rosh. They get the Aegis, and Natsumi's going to take it. But meanwhile, the back lines, MK, I'll take Cuckoo. In comes Yekka's land down as well. But BKB was out from Raven in time, able to dodge it out. And now Boomy's in some real trouble. He's going to get popped. Meanwhile, Whitemon in some trouble, getting beaten down by the army of Phantom Lancers. Adroit, they might be able to find themselves a fight here. Whitemon gets dropped. And I look over towards Carl as well. Carl, he's got that BKB. He's able to do well. TP away will be successful. There is no interrupt there. The Queen of Pain gets herself out. Lackadaisicalness from Adroit. See if they leave anybody behind. They need a couple more seconds. They're going to find Boomy here. Now, Boomy is a good target because he bought back into this one, and he's going to be dead for 75 seconds. Uh-oh. This is bad. This is Natsumi. He does have the Aegis. Maybe they can make something happen here, but Natsumi is losing his life pretty fast. He's trying to find Wyrmon here. They're trying to find at least one kill. Sonic Wave's going to cut through him. Natsumi's still alive for the time being. They're not going to be able to finish off with the Mana Void either. They're actually making this fight work for them right now. As Queen of Pain being controlled up, and now CML trying to get himself out, but it's Zephyr who's brought down in the back lines. They're going to trade with CML right now, but now Adroit, they smell blood, and they're looking for Raven. Raven with the BKB trying to find up into this one. Meanwhile, Natsumi, he's got the Aegis. He's trying to find out Carl. Carl's getting low. Can they get the kill? The science is out onto him. Can he get the blink away? He's going to get blinked up, trying to get himself over to the trees. But he's so low on HP. He's going to get himself out there. The blink is there. Geekfam, they're managing to stem the flow a little bit. Cuckoo will die. He dives back into it. Another trade here. Oh. And they actually find him. Mac jumping forwards here, able to chase down Carl, get themselves a kill. Bok again. The Exism was popped for this one. But I think they need to go. What the hell is going on back here? They catch CML, but they get Zephyr in response here. Yeah, this is a dive. It's definitely something which they can abuse. And now they find Raven. Coil's going to be used. They're going to try and blow him up here, but he's going to get off the BKB in time. With the Glimmer Cape, it doesn't seem like they have the vision on him right now. Raven happy to stand and fight, and he's got that double damage rune popped as well. Natsumi, he's being controlled up. He doesn't have that Aegis anymore. He's going to be all right there. Meanwhile, Bok popping that BKB. They're looking for Raven right now. Raven's going to be the target, but he's going to get himself out. There is not much here from Adroit, and this Chain Frost is actually doing a decent amount of work. Meanwhile, the back lines, K's being locked down. Boomy holding him still, using Echo Slam to keep K controlled up, and they will be able to bring down the Queen of Pain. 90 seconds. Dead. Adroit with the X's. Now need to head to the high ground. It's running out, but I'm wondering how much more they have to rely on it. Natsumi is hitting critical mass. Could it be possible to go without it? Well, no, because they're going onto the backlights. Mac being controlled up. The Sinister Gate's coming through as well, and they're going to be able to kill off the Pope. But meanwhile, Zephyr's in some trouble. Zephyr, though, he's actually invisible up, and they don't have a detection frame right now as they're trying to find a different target. Bok on the front lines trying to fight up. Meanwhile, they're going to be able to kill Offset from the backlights. Raven, though, still trying to play around a little bit here. He's trying to be cheeky, trying to find an opening, but he's just not finding it. And meanwhile, his supports are dying. I imagine they might be in the base waiting for the Death Prophet to respawn. Meanwhile, Raven, oh my goodness, he's in trouble. He's going to get that Aegis just disappears. Death Prophet buying back, wants to come back into this one. Meanwhile, Whitemon, he's in some real trouble being chased back into the river. Meanwhile, Boomy doing his best to lock down Raven, allowing Natsumi the time to get over here. Still got plenty of mana and able to blink himself away. Meanwhile, they're still chasing Bok and Mac on the chase. Meanwhile, the science comes out onto both of them. Raven still trying to run himself away. Coil comes out, though. He's going to pop the counter spell, trying to get himself to safety, but the coil was snapped. Oh, the damage is there. They get Raven. He's got no buyback. Meanwhile, Kay's going to get silenced up by Mac. They jump forward onto the Queen of Pain. Queen of Pain trying to run and shoot. Be successful here, and Frost Shield, it finally isn't doing enough. But 12 seconds until Anti-Mage is back. It's about to kick off, Kips. unless Adroit want to leave. But K jumps in, he's popped the BKB. Core's gonna be used onto the Queen of Pain right now. They really want to get these Mega Creeps, though. How much is it gonna cost them? They get the Mega Creeps, now can they get themselves out? Do they even want to get themselves out? Carl's gonna get dropped, does have buyback, and is gonna use it. Meanwhile,
Raven is here.
Cuckoo trying to phase it out. Meanwhile, the Death Prophet on the sideline, getting used up. Scream gonna come cutting on through. Shan, they finish the job here. Boomy gonna drop down the ultimate here, trying to control up Raven and give that team to face it. They're on top of Raven right now. Raven, he needs to get himself out and will be able to blink away, but he's still being chased. Meanwhile, Carl, he's in some trouble, being controlled up. Meanwhile, Boomy has to back himself up. That BKB is ending, but the Queen of Pain might not be so lucky. She needs to get herself out, blink forwards, but Natsumi, he's ready and waiting for her, will be able to get the kill on the steps of the base. The dive back from the Queen of Pain is so costly. Raven, you got to pull out a miracle, but getting first hit bash is not the miracle you're looking for. Abyssal going to follow up as well. Raven, he's getting low, he's running out of health, but Max actually the one in real trouble right now. The puck is going to go down. Natsumi, he looks like he's all alone all of a sudden. His team is behind him, but they are holding back. I think there has been a call from Adroit to just chill the F out, get yourselves the F away, but Zephyr says, no way, I'm coming in for this one. Geek fan, they continue to chase. That team is going to get caught out a little bit here. Meanwhile, CML trying to run himself on the side of the back lines here, but they've got him lifted up, thrown into the air. Meanwhile, Natsumi trying to get on top of Raven, but they will be able to kill off the Chen. Now Natsumi all alone fighting up into Raven, but he might actually be able to. No, blink away. They don't have to chase. Boomy does come in, trying to help this one out. Meanwhile, Cuckoo popping that BKB, trying to get himself back up to the sidelines. Astral step back into his base.
Oh, I'm not sure if it was the right decision from Raven there to blink out and leave
to die. Raven jumping back in again. The Ancient is exposed. They're trying to jump on top of him right now. Void gonna come out onto Natsumi. Natsumi is getting low. He's trying to focus the Ancient, but they're not doing nearly enough damage to it. Natsumi trying to fight up with Raven, but Raven, he's a bit of a boss right now. Meanwhile, Boomy comes in with a two-man stomp on the back lines here. They just turn around and try and rip apart this Earthshaker, but they don't have enough. Raven's gonna get dropped, but now he's got the buyback. Coming back into this one. Defending the Ancient. Can they do it? It's being attacked. Bok just trying to get the right clicks off. Natsumi as well, it's getting low, can they do it?
The Draven popping the Manta,
trying to bring down Natsumi, but it's not enough. The Aegis will fall, the Ancient will fall, and Adroit get the victory and take game number two. My God, they worked for it.
Adroit, a Geek Fam, Liz.
Yeah, Geek Fam.
Geek Fam, definitely.
Geek Fam all the way here on the panel.
Ooh, up in the top lane, Whitemon dropping a little bit lower here, and Bok, he sees him. See how that swashbuckle doesn't seem like it right now, or doesn't want to go for it anyway. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, CML maybe in a bit of trouble. Natsumi trying to fight up with him though. Cuckoo's getting low as well, and he's actually going to be the first one to drop here. CML still trying to fight up into Zephyr, and Zephyr with the spike carapace will be able to get himself away.
It's execution of some form. They can also blow up the encounters at the start of a fight, but oh, there is a hookshot onto Cuckoo, and he looks.
And it's. Ooh, okay. Ball in the Cup actually knocks Cuckoo out. And it looks like he's going to be okay for now, especially with the heals coming in out from the Oracle. But Oracle looking like a tasty little snack himself as Matt gets on top of him. And that's the Atos with the root combo, just sits on top of him and waits for him to die. Even starts hitting the Nether Ward, because why not? Who cares about Whitemon anyway? Cuckoo will come forward, though he gets a slow onto him. Meanwhile, Zephyr comes in from behind, disrupting CML. Max still tanky, and they're going to be able to bash back Raven with the Cox. Nicely done, but Max still being controlled up. In comes the Nether Ward, in comes the damage. He's so tanky. Is he actually going to get out from this one? I don't believe it. Zephyr's still chasing, but. Big Mac, that's who he is. He is a Big Mac, and they cannot chew through him. And out CML, he is going to die in the back lines anyway. And just FYI,
Spider Morph is down for another minute. Oh.
Stun. No, slow. Can't get off inside. Spike Carapace coming out. Forwards onto Cuckoo, jumping on his face right now. But CML will still be dropped.
It's one of those games where you try to catch the ball on a string, right?
Exactly. It's amazing fun for everybody. Meanwhile, we have a hookshot in the middle lane. Exactly. Cuckoo having some trouble, getting caught out, but gonna get the false promise put onto him to keep him alive. Meanwhile, Bok doesn't care about anything as he just runs himself forwards. The lifesteal not gonna get much done from the Pugna, but you know, a couple of spell spot from Adroit here, but now they're looking towards his tower. And this Boomy, by the way, level 3 Necrobook on the 4 position Enchantress. What on earth is this? And now, hey, Jesus, that's not where you wanna be. That is not where you wanna go. An interesting jump in and getting rightfully tipped by the side of Adroit. Kind of what on earth are you doing side of tip there.
Geek Fam right now, they want to capitalize immediately and...
Oh, yeah, they see the Aegis carrier though.
Popped.
That's a problem. Although Boomy's a much nicer target and yeah, he's not... Oh, Sunder coming in to save him. That's Sumi. You had Sundering his teammate, but unfortunately it's not enough to keep him alive, but we'll be able to find Zephyr at the very least. So find himself a couple of turnaround kills because Cuckoo actually gets caught out by CML. Now, Raven pops a BKB, trying to get himself up to the high ground, TPing away. Does he actually have the health to survive this? Just about does. I feel like if the Underlord had attacked in there, he would have actually dropped. But Mac looking for different targets here, trying to find Carl, and might even be able to connect onto that one. Meanwhile, the Rolling Thunder going to grab Whitemon, lower down. Meanwhile, the Roots are coming through thick and fast onto Carl here as he's making his way north. Have they found him inside? They have not got this cancel, though. They'll be able to pick him off.
They are, and it makes him so much harder to pick off with Zephyr's one. Oh, he actually got dusted immediately. This assault
okay. Box happens and choke me on a hookshot forward onto two from CML. And inside that, Petamalus as well, controlling him up nicely as Raven popping the BKB and trying to get some damage off onto CML. And CML will get dropped here. Mac in the front lines, not taking much damage though, and happy just kind of be the frontliner here. Meanwhile, Illusions pushing up down in the bottom lane. Meanwhile, they'll come forward. Zephyr's going to be the target. And Zephyr, well, it's a fight character, finds himself a little bit of time with the net coming out, the damage coming through. They'll grab that kill. Meanwhile, Mightmon gets picked off as well. They'll look forward towards his Pugna. Yul's going to come out holding him, still allowing that Zuma to get on top inside the Metamorphosis with the damage, with the kill. They will bring down Cuckoo. And now immediately, hello Barracks, the damage is coming and flying on through from Natsumi. These Barracks in the middle lane falling pretty damn fast. They are not stopping. They are stopping.
They do not have the damage.
See ya.
They have no damage at this point. They can't get anyone on the droid killed, and they have such...
This is so awkward, this is so awkward. Bond getting the three-man roll, four-man roll in the river, controlling them up and just splitting apart this fight. But GeekFam are still looking to try and help Zephyr out here, but I feel like it's a lost cause. And still, they're going to try, but Zephyr is dead. And the back lane's on Tsumi coming in on the side here. So Mielal getting low on HP, but it doesn't really matter. Meanwhile, they've got the Pugna controlled up, and Cuckoo going to lose his life. Meanwhile, Raven churning away, trying to get to the high ground. Meanwhile, Carl on the run, CML staying on top of him, but he's actually going to get chopped up by the Astral Step. Meanwhile, Bok in the front. Here's going to be Raven, though, with the BK. And he's popping that ultimate, and he's going to good town right now. How much can he get done here? Mac getting low. They have got the time if they want to try and save him, but they've got the Roots coming out. False Promise being used for Raven here, but unfortunately, he's kind of done in this fight, I feel like. His ulti's come out. He's still trying to fight up here. Natsumi going to be the target. There's a ton of damage coming out onto Raven, though. They're getting off those impetuses. They're getting off those right clicks. Meanwhile, Mac being chased down by Karl on the high ground, but Zephyr also trying to chase down Mac, but Mac is just too tanky to kill. It might not look like he's got mage HP, but he's still sitting on a ton of it. Meanwhile, Zephyr with Spike Carapace done out onto Natsumi, but now being caught out and inside that root. There's no escape. This is going to be a dead Nyx assassin. Get that Nether Ward taken down. That's not going to be an issue anymore. And now Carl netted up. High ground tower starting to crack, starting to fall. There's no frost shield, there's no repair kit. Natsumi being played around with a little bit here. He's running out of HP, but he's got the Aegis and Sunder comes out onto Carl anyway. Raven gonna pop that ultimate. He's starting to chop away at the Terrorblade. The Terrorblade doesn't even care. He's gonna get two kills whilst Raven's trying to deal with him, and he won't even do that. This game is over. The GGs are called. GeekFam, they drop out in 30 minutes to Adroit in game number two. Completely against what anybody predicted, at least on this panel, at least with us as well. That was such a good laning phase for Adroit.
Maybe the new Aghanim's Dazzle. Maybe we'll see it.
Yeah, plus they have a puck to actually keep the targets in place.
So far, so good. What kind of item build are we expecting here?
Adam Dukunka, honestly, I can't say that I'm incredibly up to date with...
Carl, he's going to get bought down. They managed to find him. Mac managed to grab him. That's the poison touch, and that is the magic of the mid Dazzle.
And right now, three heroes chasing after Cuckoo. I don't think they're actually going to get him, though. He still has his ult available. And
yeah,
don't
he's
have
a...
Quill.
He's a pretty... hard hero to kill. Meanwhile, Storm comes down to Zephyr, but they're going to respond with the Rolling Thunder. Rolling through Bok, rolling through CML, bouncing off the rocks nicely, just controlling up Bok here. But Bok, he's got plenty of health to work with still, but well, no, he doesn't anymore. Not when Mightmon pops him like that. Bok's going to dry. Mac going to die in mid lane meanwhile, and now CML could just lose his life on top of them. Yeah, GeekFam, they are tearing him up. Sometimes results in death. It's a natural life, but this isn't good. This isn't good at all. Boomy getting caught out by Kale. And
oh, no. I wasn't talking about that blink dagger for nothing, Boomy. You know it, I know it. You gotta get that thing up if you wanna be able to fight.
Dork getting tugged down in the middle lane now. Demonic Purge means he just cannot get away. He just can't escape. There's nothing he can do. GeekFam, they run down three heroes across all sides of the map right now, and now they really will open up on this middle tier 2 tower.
Now look at the uptimes on this lineup. They can just fight anytime. There's a coil, but it's only on Raven. He's pretty much the worst target.
Yeah, they're even going to throw down the Fiend's Grip onto him, but it's actually stolen by the Rubick, and now with the Rolling Thunder coming on, ripping through here, Max in trouble. They're going to run down CML, and Droid, they do not have anything to give to this fight. They lose Mac, and meanwhile, they're even finding Cuckoo on the sidelines here. Sorry, Boomy on the sidelines. Boomy trying to play with Cuckoo a bit, but yeah, the Hunter becomes a Hunted as, oh, okay, Stampede, fine. He's actually might gonna get dropped here. So Boomy finds a return kill. All right, they trade Roshan for a kill onto Zephyr. Worth it? No. Will they take it? They'll have to. Will they be happy about it?
Yes.
Probably indifferent. Meanwhile, Bok. Because he is feeling a bit like a chicken right now, getting jumped on constantly. Although they managed to get the Shallow Grave out, and he's just gonna try and run away. But unfortunately, with the disruption coming down, and Wymon's not even bothered. They're looking for the bigger kills. They're looking for Mac in the middle lane. They know he doesn't have the Shallow Grave anymore because he already used it onto the hero and he's dead. Meanwhile, Bok gets finished off by Cuckoo. He was ready to be the fielder, to catch the stray ball, and finish off this very tidy play in the middle lane. It cannot be taken on right now. But they might not have a choice. High ground is being threatened. They're coming back for it. The only one not here right now is Bane, who's using this time to get some cheeky little wards up. Meanwhile, Bok's gonna jump in, stomp and double edge, but unfortunately there's a boat heading his way as well, gonna throw down the Stampede, but it's gonna be enough to keep him alive. No, it is not. He's gonna get dropped. Another look forward to Moss. Yeah, that's gonna be the next target. He's gonna turn around, throw it down, but unfortunately, it's gonna buy them space to get out, but unfortunately, they're just gonna be on the high ground. And now, well, Natsumi's gonna come flying in to this Pangolier, who is caught inside the Fiend's Grip, but for what cause? It's Carl's able to jump on the sidelines, finish off the Bane. He does nothing, uses his ultimate and does nothing. Carl may be in a bit of trouble right now, but he's got the Aegis. He doesn't even care. He's happy to play this way. Natsumi trying to play around the sidelines here, but he can't even find a way into this fight. Shallow Grave out onto Mac, but with the stomp, with the damage, can they finish the job? Mech's gonna keep him alive for the time being. Can't dive into the fountain for it. Now Natsumi trying to find his opening here, trying to find a way to get some damage off onto Raven, but Raven is just so damn tanky. He chonk. There's nothing they can do as a tier 2 tower. Starting to get taken down here. I mean, they're slowly running out of health. Maybe there's a chance for a Droid here. Raven, he doesn't have the Aegis, and he is going to die. Finally, Natsuki finding his players. They run onto Whiteman here. Whiteman's going to drop as well. Two heroes dead on the side of Geek Fam.
It is definitely not this region. Yeah, K up on the high ground. Zephyr, moving into
Dazzle. Cuckoo, he's getting beat him down. He doesn't have that BKB. The money purchased onto him as well. He's trying to heal himself up as best he can. There's that BKB coming to cooldown. Thank you, Bad Juju. Meanwhile, they're going to throw down the ultimate from the Bane onto Cuckoo, trying to control him up. Bok is going to die on the front lines. He's got a buyback, going to throw it out here. Natsumi's still trying to find an entrance into this fight, but whilst he's waiting to find his opening, the barracks are falling. Range racks are down. Melee barracks heading the same way as well. It's starting to fall, and it is not looking great for the side of a Droid. Natsumi, what can you do? He's waiting. In they go with the stomp. This is the start of the fight they're looking for. Bok taking damage, but they might be able to bring down Wymon, but Wymon's going to disrupt himself, and Bok is the one in trouble. In comes the saving grace from the Dazzle. Meanwhile, Wymon does go down in the back lines, but Bok is going to trade his life for that one. Meanwhile, Cuckoo in some trouble. Essence Ring helping him out a little bit, but the PL, he's getting work done, but now he needs to run. X Marks out is onto him. He's in some trouble. Is he going to die here, though? He's got the Shallow Grave coming out nice and early. He's going to try and continue to fight as he has buyback. It could be something, and he will continue just to spam out these doppels. K is running out of mana, by the way. This could be trouble. I think he kind of wants to die here so he can get that mana back, but they're just ignoring him and going for the sideline. Zephyr's going to drop here. Now they look towards K, finish him off. Raven can't go for the TP. What? He's going to get killed off as well. Droid, they lose their barracks, but they find themselves a whole bunch of kills. But hold the phone, they might not be done, because in comes Cuckoo on the back lines, isolating Carl and allowing him to nearly finish off CML. Not able to quite do it.
So... you can hex people and you can keep them hexed.
Here we go again, it's Bungie time, baby. Don't look at Carl, look at the tower. The Yules comes down, so he's going to be trapped on the high ground a little bit here. They're slowing him down, they're trying to break him down. Now they're going to use the Fiend's Grip as well, but the BKB is out from Carl, meaning it's hard for him to take any damage here. And it is just going to be a wasted Fiend's Grip as Carl is happily just skipping around on the high ground. Tower down to about a quarter HP as they go in with the three-man coil. Not bad. Now the Poison Touch going to follow up as well as Natsumi gets to work. Pop that BKB, trying to take down Cuckoo. They've got the hex out onto him. Can they bring down the Pangolier in time? He's surviving, he's up to the high ground, he's living, and now he's going to pop the Rolling Thunder and come flying back into this fight, disrupting Bok and Natsumi as they are taking care of the backline. CML has dropped, but buys back into this one. Mac meanwhile in trouble, the Dazzle taken out of this fight. No escape for him. And now Natsumi finds himself a little bit alone, but still able to find himself a way through to the backline to this fight. It's the Puck who's in trouble. Yules is out. He's got an orb heading over, and he's going to be able to jump to it. So Boomy will survive. They only lose the Dazzle. It's something. They're holding on. Cool. But, I mean, still, buying time. Natsumi on the back line, so he's going to pop that BKB and try and find somebody here, but he's all alone. They're trying to make their way over. The rest of his team trying to meet him as Bog jumps in, trying to get a stun. This gun K up, but meanwhile, the rest of the team has to back away, and Phantom Lance with a double on Tim can't actually turn to his fight until Dominic Purge is gone. Now they come flying back through. Meanwhile, it's an extremely split fight for now. Maybe this could save them, but Buck and the back line is going to get bound. They're going to take advantage of the space he's made on the front lines of the fight. No, because K is rampaging through two heroes, taking down them both. Dazzle is coming back in 1 second. It's going to be a three-man defense, but 3-on-5. The math simply does not add up for a droid. It is not looking good. It's a desperate move. Natsumi just flying in, but the Ancient is starting to fall, and it looks like GeekFam will be able to finish this one up as Natsumi drops along with the Ancient. GG. GeekFam take game number 4, equaling out the series to a 2-2. Yes, this is the final game here for the SEA region. Yeah, these lanes, we'll see if they can swap something up. And now actually the Raid's going to show himself onto Whitemon here. They're blocking him up and with the cogs coming through as well. Battery Assault controlling him up, but it's not that much damage. And meanwhile, Boomy's actually the one in trouble. Whitemon will be a First Blood though. Boomy, is he going to go down in response? It doesn't look like it. He's running himself away. First Blood. Are they looking for more
here? Extremely defenseless. Oh. And they are actually taking this huge Ancient stack right now. Raven needs to make his way over. There's just four heroes here. I'm not sure he can contest.
Yeah, Raven's running. He's running, and he sees him, and he's like, well, that's not my stack anymore. Throwing some stuns their way, you know, trying to force them to react. And to be honest, they haven't taken the big creeps yet. The big one still remains, so Sven's not going to be completely sad about this. Meanwhile, K, he's playing around with Boomy right now inside that arena. And meanwhile, oh my goodness, CML just gets cut through as the Ice Blast comes firing through from overhead. And now GeekFam, they're really looking for this fight as they're going to pop the God Strength. Boomy in trouble. Can he get taken down? Meanwhile, Zephyr inside that doggy form as they continue fighting for this one. Stun gets thrown out. The way of Natsumi. Natsumi on the run, trying to get away inside the shape. But meanwhile, the wraparound from a droid is actually successful as you bring down Karl and Zephyr. Whose fight really is this? Is GeekFam lose 3? I guess I feel like his early game was diffused so much that he just decided, you know what, I'm just going to wait until this next timing and go for that one instead. But, you know, all the cores on the side of the Radiant all kind of ganging up in this little bubble here. They're more than happy about it. Meanwhile, Boomy's going to be the one initiated on right now with the God Strike pop from the Spen. He's got a ton of damage to throw down here, trying to deal with the Necro units, but in comes Arena with the Ravage as well onto so many heroes. Boomy gets cut up. Zephyr dead as well. It's a 1-for-1 right now, but with Matt going down, GeekFam feeling pretty good about this one as they look forward towards Bok. Bok trying to get himself away. Where will you go, though? Where is the out exit? It's just not there, and Spen's going to tear him a new one. Bok gets brought down. And in they go, Raven finds CML in the back line to this fight. Ice Blast coming in over the top as well, but it's already too late. CML gets dropped. Meanwhile, Mac doing a good job on taking the damage of the Spen. And I think this means that they think they can go for this one. A droid
TPing
in, buying back. They want to try and take this one, but the Spen has no damage. Is it going to be enough? In comes the Arena, taking down Cuckoo here. There's your Ravage being gone. Meanwhile, the Lycan chasing more in the back lines. Cuckoo gets dropped, and now, well, Natsumi, he's looking for the other kills, and they're going to bring down Zephyr, and it looks like Whitemon going to be heading the same way, 100-0 in 0, as they grab themselves 3. Black King Bar in his pocket, ready to show it off to the GeekFam lineup, and they're going to go for a shapeshift. Hookshot beautifully coming in onto Raven. He does manage to pop the BKB before the spear connects. Now Boom's in some trouble inside his own cocks, trying to break his way out, but the crit comes through. Raven gets a kill. Whitemon taking down to the back lines. Meanwhile, Cuckoo in the front lines. He's having trouble. Makes it up to the high ground, though. Natsumi still chasing. I'm not sure we want to do this, though, buddy. He's actually getting controlled up onside the high ground and gets killed off by the Spen.
Get that off on the Spen. That could be pretty big. Yeah, he's throwing out some spells. Shapeshift being used as well around the back lines here from Zephyr, as he's sensing something is wrong. Blinking forwards here, immediately trying to get the initiation out onto Bok, and he just gets disintegrated. Meanwhile, there's a Tidehunter on the back lines trying to find the extra heroes, and they're not going to be able to get off the ultimate just yet from the Tide. It's being bullied up by Boom. Now, in comes Natsumi. He's got the ultimate. They're going to try and take down Whitemon, and there's a Ravage coming through, but the BKB is out from Mark and from Natsumi. They start to take Raven apart. They've got a Sightling onto him. He realizes there's something he can do, but he can't even TP away. Raven is dead on the Spen, and actually a droid do fire this fight. It seemed like a bit of a risky play, but when you get that sight link on the Spen, as we mentioned time and time again, that is the biggest play you can make in these fights. And when don't make that, it just becomes so, so hard for GeekFam. And we Mortawellen. We Ward. Uh-oh, here it comes. Hookshot forwards. They don't know Cuckoo's here. He's giving them so much vision. Uh-oh, never mind. They do know he's here. They've got it disrupted up. He's controlled up on the cliff, and that's the spider legs out. Meanwhile, Raven's getting controlled up on the front lines. They've got the Sonic Link. Can they finish him off? Yes, they can. The Fen is dead, and down goes Zephyr with him. That is a great 2 kills for Adroit here, finding the perfect entry into this one. I don't know how they spotted the Tidehunter up there, but that was
not good.
Mortal Kombat got the whole knockback. Hookshot forward onto Kay. They're controlling up right now, but I don't think they've got enough. He's got an astral step in 3 seconds. Hookshot forwards, but no, he doesn't make it. Just about gets caught out by that one. He does have buyback, but this is a huge dent in his Rapier gold. That was the kind of Hail Mary play from GeekFam. And they're just straight onto the high ground. Fortification comes out. They really want this buyback from the Void Spirit. Meanwhile, smoke up from GeekFam. They're looking for an entry to the spot. And then they go with the God Strength, trying to bring down Mac. Mac is a big damage dealer. And with the Ravage coming through and the Ice Blast as well, they annihilate him. And now look for more. Bok sitting on the front lines, but CML does not stand a chance. Meanwhile, Bok gets himself back, being chased. But GeekFam have managed to hold on to this one. But they did actually buy back on Karl anyway, which I feel is maybe not the play, but whatever. They're getting on top of Bok now. They're getting on top of the Mars, and the Mars will be brought down.
It's pretty much over for GeekFam anyway.
But they're going to risk it. They're going on Mac right now. They're trying for this one. This is the guy with the Satanic, but with the Ice Blast coming through, they're going to be able to take him down for this first life very, very efficiently using that Stolen Arena of Blood. But in comes Boomy, going for the hook shot, trying to go for more here. Can he find anybody? Meanwhile, the Rubik steals the hook shot. Raven trying to get Mac here, but Mac just stealing all of his damage. And with that Static Link, it's basically GeekFam's chance of fighting kind of gone. And now the hook shot's onto Kay. He needs to get himself out. This is a Rapier carry, but he's being chased. The Raven's going to be used to try and keep Kay alive. And now he's actually looking to turn back into this one. And they're able to bring down that Natsumi. But they lose Mac as well as GeekFam find the opening. They don't need their spend when you have a Rapier on your Void Spirit, and he's just coming through, cleaning up hero after hero after hero. 3 dead, and they're looking for more. Boomy's going to be the next target, and, well, Boomy, unfortunately, is going to live up to his name here and explode in just a minute. Tankier than I would have imagined. There we go. There we go. The big damage comes in. The Void Spirit is there, and he can tear him up super easily.
Yeah. Ale flying in, though. Cuckoo is on his way.
Boomy is going to get picked off whilst they're doing this, but Roshan should fall, I would imagine. Yep, Mac's going to grab the Aegis. Meanwhile, they manage to distract them for long enough. Boomy perfectly happy with this one, going for the double hookshot, just locking them down. And they actually get rid of the Void Spirit and grab the Rapier on the side. Oh, this is just an absolute disaster here. Raven trying to fight up, but he's just trading damage with Mac right now. Does have a decent amount, but in comes a disruption from CMJ on them still. Ravage comes out a little bit too early, but they still do take away that Aegis off the Razor. Can they still take this fight as Bog comes in with a big slap onto Raven, taking down that Sven, and now they look forward for more. Cuckoo's going to get ripped in two. It seems like this might have been GeekFam dropping the ball a little bit. So Bok still holding on to the Quickening Charm after all of this, and
Max
now
Mars
jumping in. Abyssal comes out, Raven on the front lines as well, connecting to one another once again, but they're refreshing and going for the second one. Raven, he's losing his life. He's going to die here. No buyback on him, and Karl dropping as quickly. They just get absolutely demolished. Where did they go? What happened? I think that's it. There's 3 heroes left to try and defend this one, but 2 Rapiers now fed away to the side of a Droid, and I just don't think there's anything left. They're ripping through the back door. They don't care about this. They don't care about anything right now. They'll turn him into a pig. They'll desolate Zephyr, and Zephyr gets destroyed, and the GGs are called. Ha ha ha. GG is called by K, and that is going to be the end of the game, and a Droid will take the series versus GeekFam in a thrilling 5-game series.